Welcome back, Woodhounds, to the Back 40 Firewood channel. Back here in the woodyard today, and I first wanted to just say thanks for all the feedback on the video about stacking wood in stacks or in the pile. The one thing I didn't really make clear is that even if I did stack this wood, it probably wouldn't be under a roof, so it'd end up being in stacks like that. The thing I was trying to get across with showing you the woodshed wood inside under the roof was the fact that if you took the middle of that five stacks, if you took the middle row and on the very bottom, the surrounding area around that wood was just thick stacked wood, similar to the bottom of this pile. But after reading all the feedback, it does seem like it's a divided topic, as it was with the discussions I had before. So what I think I'm going to do is I am going to add a little bit more to this pile here, but I am going to look for some room to build out and stack some more wood. Because like I said, I do have a lot of wood there, and I've got back there a lot of oak to split up. And the oak especially I want to get stacked. But today we've got the amazing Amanda here to help us. We're going to run. What I'm kind of doing now is, with all those rounds that I have piled up over there, I'm going through and I'm loading up a bucket full of rounds that are about the same diameter that will all go through the six-way wedge one pass. So we're going to bring over the bucket. We're going to split it. Amanda's going to be tossing it onto the pile, building on to what we already have right there. Laid down two more pallets, so we're just going to keep extending this back. And we'll see. I mean, maybe by the end of summer, I might start taking some of this and stacking it up, you know, where I have room. We'll see. But again, appreciate all the feedback. Great discussion. I love it. I love that kind of stuff. When I can throw something out there, I can get feedback from all you woodhounds on things that you've tried and experiences you've had. So greatly appreciate that. So, all right, we're gonna get this set up. I'm gonna get the bucket over here full of wood, get the splitter warmed up, and we're gonna get split done.
Are these?
All right, so we went through that bucket pretty quick. That six-way wedge makes all the difference. One push, done, right through. But now I've got some bigger stuff here. So I'm gonna have to switch back to the four-way and break it down, you know, into manageable pieces. Roadside stand, bundle grade pieces. The amazing man that had to run, and the little boss man wanting to go swimming. So she's over watching him in the pond. So I'm gonna finish splitting this stuff up here. And once again, thanks everyone for all the feedback and suggestions on stacking the wood or leaving it in a pile. I think what I will end up doing is leaving some of this here for to season, but I'm also now, I've got a couple spots picked out where I think I'm gonna try to expand with some stacks and get things stacked up. So the one thing I did need to consider when I'm where I'm putting wood back here is I need to be able to get back here in the winter and push the snow around. So like I could, you know, stack wood back here, but that's like my main lane for pushing snow, or it's going to be the main lane for pushing snow right out that way. So I don't want to put stacks back there. And I've got a couple spots picked out over there. They're a little bit further away. Get this bug out of here, but we'll see. Once I get more of that stuff cleaned up right there, I will have some room in there to work with. But like I said, I do want to kind of leave a little bit of a pile here just to see how that stuff dries out and seasons. Even if I keep splitting all this wood, I think this pile is just going to get too big anyway. So eventually I'm going to have to start stacking again. But for now, I'm just going to keep splitting this stuff off onto this pile. And if there's an afternoon where I feel like doing some stacking, I might grab some wood off of here and stack it. We'll see. We'll see how that goes. We'll cross that bridge when we get there. But for now, that's the plan. We're going to keep building Mount Woodmore, Mount Woodhound, whatever we ended up calling this thing. And then I'm going to get my new spot picked out. Keep splitting all this stuff up. There's still a lot of wood there. That's why it's... The wood is adding up, which is great. It's also great that I decided to move back here and not keep my operation up front, because I would definitely be out of room then. So that's going to do it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It's a nice afternoon here under the canopy. The sun is out. It's hot. Boss man swimming. Amazing Amanda's probably swimming as well. And as soon as I get done splitting this stuff up, I'll probably be jumping in to cool off myself. So we'll see you guys next time. Stay safe, have fun, and be cool.